Hello, my name is Martin and this is 3D Printing Iceland. In this video I'm going to do a review of the Polyalchemy PLA filament I've purchased. I want to note that this filament was bought by my own money and it's not a sponsored video or a paid review. It's just my thoughts on this filament I bought with my own money. So let's have a look after the intro. So this filament is a very special filament in the way how it looks. It's a PLA based filament that is a very shiny filament, and when you print with it the layers fuse well together, so you get a very good surface. When I first saw this filament on some YouTube video, I really want to get this filament, and finally I found a reseller that was able to ship to Iceland and got this filament. I had a few rolls for quite some time and just ordered several more, and I did some prints with all the colors I got, and I want to first show you the results of the synthetic test that I normally do, and then I will show you the models that I really think the filament shines with the organic models. So let's have a look at the first prints. One of the first prints I normally do with a filament is this stringing test, and I was having a little bit of stringing when printing at 225 degrees, and the problem I have in this print, I'm not getting very good layer adhesion, and I was increasing the temperature a little bit. I had first printing at 205 degrees and had very poor layer adhesion. So that was an issue I was trying to resolve by increasing the temperature, and at 225 I got pretty decent prints without having too much shrinking, so I sticked with 225 degrees, so this came out pretty good. Overhang tests also came out decent. There's a slight more defects here on the part that was facing away from the fan, and that's pretty much expected. When the part is facing away from the fan, it has a little bit more drooping, but the ends look quite nice, and this is the main fault of the filament. It's not very strong, so I can easily break it, so that's something you have to take into account. You're not going to do mechanical parts that are strong. I then printed out my brake tests, and this one is printed like this on the bed, and this one like this on the bed, so I can check for layer adhesion. For this one, it's quite easy to break it, even though I'm breaking against the layers, so it was not very strong. And for this one that has the layers here, it's very easy to break, so layer adhesion is not very good. For this print, there's a bridging test here that came out pretty good, and the overhang tests also came out pretty good. There's a little bit of stringing, but nothing too serious, but as the layer adhesion is not very good, it's very easy to break off the parts, and that is maybe the only problem I have with this filament. It's not very strong in layer adhesion, and it's quite easy to break, so strength is not something that is good in this filament. Here then, the bridging test, that came out excellent. And here there's only one strand in the longest band, but otherwise the bridging was very good, so I was getting very good bridging. As you can see, it's very clean. And then printed out a few of my maker coins, and they were coming out excellent, and the shine of the filament really starts to show through on this organic model. You can see how it shines. It's very good looking, and the details in the letters were pretty good, so there's nothing to complain about on those prints. And I printed up three coins with the same settings just to get more coins. It's coming out excellent. I then printed out Mr. Belly. It's just a test model I created, and that also came out pretty good. So for trinkets like this, it looks really good, but layer adhesion is again not very good, so it's very easy to break it apart. So Mr. Belly has this is like a test piece to check for print quality and layer adhesion, and it's not very strong model. So if the filament has poor layer adhesion, it's very easy to break the legs off, and that was basically the purpose of this model, to test out filaments and and show the print on how layer adhesion is. To show you how the rolls are, the filament rolls, it's in a clear plastic filament rolls, and they are very sturdy rolls, and they have a desiccant inside here, and they have a good like slot here that the desiccant rolls in, and you don't have to take it out, so it's a good thing to have the desiccant just laying there even though you're printing. But the filament is really shiny. You can see how it is on the roll. It's pretty good. So I was quite happy with those rolls. They are very strong. Here's one object I printed out. This is like a infinity triangle thing. It is very, very nice. And it's just made up of triangles and holes in the shape of triangles. And this is printed in a nightshade purple, and it's very dark purple, and maybe shows up in camera as a black or a dark blue, but it's a purple color, and it's excellent model. And this is actually printed in vase mode for and it's very, very light model. And then I printed out my vase, and in this print it really shines how the surface of this filament is. You can see how it is reflecting the light, and it's very clean, and the layers are very well stuck together, so you really can't see the layer lines in the print. And this is printed at 0.2 millimeter layer height. It's difficult to see that it's not a finer detail with a smaller layer height, but this is coming out excellent. And this vase, as you can see how the lights play around in the model, it's just awesome looking. So that is coming out great. And then printed out a big benchy, and this is a very cool cool looking benchy. It is absolutely perfect in regards of print quality. It's has no issues whatsoever, and this is printed on my Prusa MK3 printer, and this is looking very cool. I've had this benchy on my shelf for showing off this filament, and people have noticed this filament when they come to visit me, and this is looking awesome. And the filament for a model like this, like a showpiece or this, that's where it's really shines through. And finally, I have an army of Veronoi cats, and here I printed out a cat with all the filament colors I got. So those are the colors I got, and it's absolutely awesome colors. They're very bright colors, and in a model like this, it's really shines the filament, and it's looking awesome. So those cats are gonna be just on a shelf here at my home, just for show. they are looking awesome, and for something like this, this is where this filament shines, and you're not gonna do mechanical parts with great success with this filament, but for something that you are creating, like an art or a statues or something that you're gonna show off, it's absolutely beautiful. And I hope to print a lot of things like this with this filament when I have to print something that needs to look very good. So that was the reason I got this filament. I want to get as many colors I could get. So this is an awesome selection of colors. I think they have a few more colors available, but and they are constantly adding colors. I think this gold rush color is the newest color they created. And I really like this pink color. It's absolutely awesome. And then this blue color is also very good. So. And this yellow is very bright yellow. It's one of the brightest yellow color you can get, I think. So those were the thoughts I had on the Polyalchemy Elixir PLA filaments. They are awesome looking filaments that you can use for all kinds of showpieces. And they're not very good for mechanical parts because of bad layer adhesion, and they're not very strong even when I was breaking them across the layers. So don't use it for mechanical parts, but for art pieces like those cats here, and some vases and some things you want to show off, it's absolutely beautiful filament, and it's really easy to print with. I was printing at 225 degrees on my Prusa, otherwise just with normal PLA settings, and I raised the temperature up a little bit to get a little bit better layer adhesion. But they say on the box the recommended temperature is 200 to 220 degrees Celsius, so I was just upping that a little bit. So this filament is something I would highly recommend if you have some projects like art pieces or show off pieces, what you can do with a 3D printer. It's absolutely beautiful filament. And the problem I had with this filament was mainly the layer adhesion and strength. Otherwise, I was getting a difficulty to order the filament. I had ordered 3 rolls from Ben at Hawk 3D Proto in the UK, and but they closed shop not so long ago, and I finally found 3D Filaprint, a reseller in the UK that was agreeing to send to Iceland. They didn't have Iceland as a shipping option, but I sent them a tweet and asked if they could add Iceland to their list of destinations, and they did, so I ordered more rolls. Yeah, so that was basically my thoughts on this filament. Like I said in the beginning, this was not a sponsored review or something like that. I bought this filament with my own money, so this is just my thoughts on the filament. So I hope you liked the video, and I'll see you in the next one.